Namaste everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Dr. Abhishek Kumar. Today we are going to learn about the development of internal ear, and make sure to see our previous video by clicking on I button. So internal ear is the first of the three part of the ear to develop in the fourth week of intrauterine life. Now we will see the formation of otic vesicle with a very simple diagram. This is the surface ectoderm we are making, and this one is neural tube. In blue color, this is called otic pellicle. In yellow color, called neural tube. So the surface ectoderm on either side of the mesencephalon saw a localized thickening called the otic pellicle, and the otic pellicle soon invaginate under the mesoderm to form a otic pit. So the invagination, you can see in this diagram how the invagination is taking place. Otic pit. So the margin of otic pit approach each other and fuse together to form a otic vesicle. The otic vesicle gets separated from the surface of the ectoderm. In blue color, you can see on both the side how the separation of the otic vesicle take place from the surface ectoderm. So this complete the formation of the otic vesicle. Now we will proceed to the development of membranous labyrinthine. So in this diagram we will be going to see how the development of membranous labyrinthine will take place here. Now this one is called otic vesicle, and here is a endolymphatic sac. So one thing I forgot to say, the otic vesicle is a primordium of the membranous labyrinthine, and otic vesicle then grow and form a various part of the membranous labyrinthine of the internal ear. As you can see, the two color, the utricular portion and the secular portion. Secular portion is called cochlear part, and the utricular portion is called vestibular part. So remember, in red color it is there, and this all together is called semicircular duct, and this is utricle. And in blue color, saculae and cochlea. Now the secular portion of the otic vesicle give rise to the saculae cochlear duct, that is also called as organ of Corti, and a spiral ganglion of the vestibulocochlear nerve. The utricular portion of the otic vesicle give rise to the utricle, semicircular duct, endolymphatic duct and sac, and the various ganglion of the vestibulocochlear nerve. So we'll label the semicircular duct and the utricle in red color, and in blue color we'll label the saculae and the cochlea. And during the sixth week of intrauterine life, the saculae form a tubular diverticulum, the cochlear duct that grow in a spiral fashion till it completes the second and half turns. Later it connect with the saculae and become a narrow forming ductus reunion. The mesenchymum condense around the membranous labyrinthine. This condensation is converted into a cartilage to form a otic capsule. The space between the otic capsule and the membranous labyrinth is called the perilymphatic space, The cartilage of the otic capsule is converted into a bony part to form a bony labyrinth. The perilymphatic space between the bony labyrinth and the membranous labyrinth is filled with the fluid called the perilymphatic fluid. Now we'll label this one as utricle and the ampullae and the semicircular duct. You can see on the screen all the things very clearly. And this one is called endolymphatic duct and sac. Endolymphatic duct and sac is there on your skin. This one is called utricosacular duct. Utricular sacular duct. This one is called utricular sacular duct. And this point is called saculae. And this part is called ductus reunion. And this one is called ductus reunion. This one is duct of cochlea, or called cochlear duct, or it is organ of Corti also. In blue color we'll label this one. This complete the development of membranous labyrinth. I hope you understand whole diagram. It will be very helpful in your exam to draw. So in next we'll see the development of perilymphatic space around the cochlear duct. That is incorrect. I wrote that is not perilymphatic duct, that is a perilymphatic space, and this is modulus and the otic capsule which attach together. And this one is cochlear duct is there. Here is perilymphatic duct space, that is not perilymphatic duct and modulus. And in pink color pen will draw various part, the secular part, and with the help of pink color pencil we'll draw all the various. Scala vestibuli is separated from the duct of the vestibular membrane. Vestibular membrane is also called as Reisner's membrane. If I will be not spelling out the spelling very correctly, you can note it down the spelling, that is R-E-I-S-S-N-E-R apostrophe S, Reisner's membrane. The scala tympani is separated from the duct of the basilar membrane. Then it get to the lateral end of the cochlear duct, is attached to the surrounding cartilage by a spiral ligament, where its medial end is connected to a long cartilaginous process that is called modulus, which is also a future axis of the bony cavity of the cochlea. So you can see all the diagram here. Now we'll see the development of and the derivatives of internal ear, embryonic structure and adult derivatives of internal ear. We'll write the secular portion. Secular portion give rise to the saculae and the cochlear duct, which is the adult derivatives of the secular portion. And the second one is the utricular portion, which give rise to the utricle, semicircular duct, endolymphatic duct and the sac. This complete the development of internal ear. Thank you very much.